Hey guys, welcome to Web Coding. So in this video, we are going to discuss another new question of arrays and string series, that is my bulb switcher. So let's discuss what this question says. In this question, we'll be given n bulbs. It means we have n bulbs, number, their numbering start from 0 to n minus 1. And our task is to obtain a particular configuration. We'll be given a configuration of bulb. So we have to obtain that configuration. Initially, all of our bulbs are switched off. Then we'll be given a target. So we have to make our configuration, all of the bulb, equal to our target. Okay, it means in a particular, in our target, our, if target of I is 1, it means our target will be given in a string form. So if our target of I is 1, it means our, in that configuration that we have to achieve, that bulb is on. And if the target of I is 0, it means that bulb in that particular configuration is off. So we will be having a switch to flip the state of our bulb. And a flip operation is defined as follows. So each bulb, we have a we have a switch to flip the bulb. All right. And now let's discuss what the flipping of bulb is. So it says choose any bulb from index I of your current configuration. And flip each bulb from index I to an index n minus 1. All right. When any bulb is flipped, it means that if it is 0, its state changes to 1, and if it is 1, it changes to 0. So let's discuss what flipping is here. Let's say initially I have 5 bulbs. Initially all of my bulbs are switched off. So now let's discuss first of all what is flip operation. Okay. So here flip operation says if I'm at this particular index, right? And if I flip this bulb, it means it is going to flip all of the bulbs till n minus 1. From this index to n minus 1. Flip means it is going to change the state of all of the bulbs from this index to n minus 1. So now my configuration becomes like this. If I were at this index and if I flip this configuration, it was going to be like this. Okay. So I think now flip operation is clear to you. Now let's say initially all of my bulbs are 0 and we have to attain any configuration. Let's say all my bulbs are 0, 0, 0, 0. Of that is now we have to attain. And our target is this 1011. Okay, so initially I haven't flipped it yet. So my flip is initially 0 and my current is here. My current is initially 0. Alright. Okay. So now let's discuss our approach. Initially, I am at this particular index. My current is 0 and my flip is also 0. Okay. So and this is my target. So I am going to match this, compare these two. And if both of these are not same, it means this is 1 and this is 0. So it means I have to make this, I have to turn this on. I have to turn this bulb on, right? Because it's on in my configuration. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to flip this 0. So now if I'm going to flip this 0, I'm going to switch it on. So it is going to flip all of the bulbs from index I to n minus 1, right? I is 0, n minus 1 is 4, right? Okay, so this is my state. This is my initial state. That is, I can say state 0. This is my state 1. Alright. Now, after that, I come here in my target. I match it. And I match this. Both are unequal. It means I have to switch it off. Because in my configuration, it switched off. So, this is my state 2. I again flip. Initially, I flipped here one time. So, it flip was 1. Now, I again flip. So, my flip is 2. So, 1, 0. And then 0, 0, 0. Okay. This is my state 2 and my current was before what 1, so now my current is 0. Okay, so make it 0. All right, now I check my current here and then check my target of I. So here both are unequal, it means I have to flip again. So my flip is 3 now and my state is changed to 101111. All of these bulbs are flipped. This is my state. Now my current is what? After every flip, my current is changing, right? Here I flipped. My current was 0. Current was 1 here. So current was changed to 0 here. Here I flipped. So my current is 1 here. Alright? Okay. So my current is now 1. Now I am going to check my current with my target of I. Both are equal. So we won't be doing anything. Means there will be no flip. Flip operation performed. Again, I am going to check this with my current. Both are equal. Means there will be no flip operation. All right, and then we have achieved our target, right? So it means we need 3 flips here. Okay, So we will be having a current and a flip variable, and then we'll be solving it. Okay, so let's write some code. Yeah, initially I will be taking a flip variable which is equal to 0 now. Initially, then current is also initially equal to 0. Now I will traverse over my target array. Target dot length i++. Again, I'm going to check if my current is equal to target dot char at i. If both of these are equal, then do what? Then do no, nothing. Means there will be no flip operation. Otherwise, do what? Otherwise, flip plus plus. And current will be equal to target dot char at i. Right? And then return the flip. Alright, now let's try to run this. Okay, successful. And now let's try to submit this. Some test cases are failing here. Let's see. Okay, it will be target. I have to make these two integers. We cannot compare integer and character. Now it will work fine. Okay, submitted. So this was my approach. This was my algorithm. This, or I can say, approach to solve my bulb switcher for 4. So I hope guys you like this video, and I hope I was able to make it clear to you guys. And if you like this video, please like, share and comment. Thanks for watching.